So let's talk about a little bit about the book. It's about 10 chapters, and the first is to explain to people who are not into the accountability of marketing what the concept means and why should you be accountable, and the four main reasons why marketeers should be working on it. And the first one, I think, is the most promising, most inspiring one for the marketeers, because most marketeers, they have had the experience that they've made a new marketing plan, new business plan by the end of the year. It's all agreed upon by the senior management. They've got their budget. And then during the next year, when they execute this plan, somewhere in March, May, April, I don't know exactly, the management says, yeah, we need some extra money for some other activities in the company, other projects, and they take it away from marketing because marketing is not accountable. But if they're accountable, they're in the boardroom, and it will be very difficult for senior management just to take away budget from marketing without decreasing the goals they have. So that's the first most important reason, I think, for marketeers itself. Then the second chapter is all about the marketing cycle, the accountable marketing cycle, which starts with the strategy, then it goes to how you organize your company, to marketing, to the campaigns, and from the campaigns back to marketing performance management. What have we done in marketing and where should we make some changes? Then the third chapter is all about this quote, and we all, well, maybe not everybody here, but most people in marketing or business economics business, they have heard this quote, 50% of my marketing budget is wasted. I don't know which 50%. And it was thought that it is Lord Leverhulme, one of the founders of Unilever as it is today, who has said this before. So in chapter three, we go into this, where is the wasted marketing budget? And then the fourth chapter is where people are interested in. They say, yeah, nice story, Michiel. And you told us we have to invest in accountability of marketing. We have to collect data, we have to do some research. So that takes also a part of the marketing budget. So what's the return of accountability itself? And that's explained in the fourth chapter, where I also explain the pre and post ROI. Return on investment means how much money in sales or in profit do I get back from the investment I've done. And the pre and post means that before I start a campaign, I ask my marketeers to develop a campaign, to think about what they're going to do, what steps are in, which media are used, and so they know all the cost and they have a best guess about the results. So they can, for me, can calculate what should be the return investment before I start the campaign, and the post ROI is after the campaign. And it should meet, and therefore it says a little bit larger or equal to the hurdle rate, which means I give the marketeers the goal that they should meet a return on investment of, let's say, 15%, because the money I give them costs the company money too, so we need to have a return on investment on the money at least of 15%, and that's what we called the hurdle rate. So it's a hurdle where you have to jump over. Then the fifth chapter is about a funnel, and a funnel means it's a smaller. Every step you get a smaller tunnel in Dutch, maybe a funnel. It's going smaller because you're looking at the world and the whole world can be your customer. But if you go into marketing, you get to smaller groups and then finally you get to the people who really are your customer, your clients. And I've added an extra part of this because most of the times the funnel stops after sales. So now we know marketing and sales, they have to work together to have a good results in the marketing activities. But I would take it a step further and what I call service. So when people are my customers, I would like to treat them nicely. I would like to inform them, help them when they have problems. But also, I would like to check whether these are nice customers. Like for an insurance company, it's very nice that we have an ad in a newspaper and a lot of customers come in from this ad. So we're very happy at marketing and sales. But then we find out that these people forget to pay their insurance money, and that they're calling our call center with all kinds of claims which are not included in their insurance. So that gives you an information that service is also needed to understand which part of the market we would like to have. Then chapter six, it's all written by Guy Powell about modeling, and how you can use data to get a better picture of your marketing activities and see before you run your campaigns to see whether the results will be very good or nice. Then the seventh chapter is about automation. There's a lot about to do, especially on the internet. You can completely automate your campaign from start till the customers are in there and afterwards as well. So there's a lot about to do about automation, which is also one of the reasons why accountability of marketing has become so hot, because the automation helps people, marketeers, to be accountable. Then the eighth one, it's about culture, getting sales and marketing together on the same page. Make sure that the leads that marketing is delivering are also the leads that sales would like to have. And you have to make some changes in your company, especially in the marketing department, when you want to be accountable. Then the ninth chapter, here's a picture of the C-suite, so-called C-suite. That's where you see all the C's are in there, all the titles of the senior management. And is it a question of top-down? Or senior management tells everybody you have to be accountable? Or is it bottom-up that we have to come up with some ideas from the marketing department how we would like to be accountable? And then the last chapter is helping the people. Okay, I've read all this information in the book, and now I would like to start with the accountability of marketing. And there's a 10-step plan in the last chapter to help you work out the accountability of your own company, whether it's a small company or you have a real large marketing department. So from Dutch to English, and also updated, not just the translation, took me about 5 years, as you can see here. But I'm very happy that we're here together to celebrate the presentation of this book. Maybe some of you have clicked on the link in the invitation I've sent you, and there was a very nice discussion with Laura Patterson of Vision Edge Marketing and Guy Powell. Guy Powell wrote the foreword, and he has written a couple of other books about the accountability of marketing. And Laura Patterson, I follow her for a couple of years already, so we know each other actually only through the internet. And she's working on all kinds of dashboards for marketing. So we have had a very nice discussion about the accountability of marketing. And that's where I would like to be. This is a picture taken on Mount Kenya, which is also part of my journey, because I took some extra energy and inspiration on the Mount Kenya to finish and finalize this book instead of keeping it as an idea in my head. And I would like to be the man here on the rock, helping other marketeers, business owners, to make sure they get to the top of their accountability of marketing. So thank you very much for your interest, for being here today, and for celebrating with us the presentation of Yes, Accountable Marketing. And I hope for all marketeers that they will be proud when the CEO shows up or the business owner shows up and asks them what are the results of marketing, and they can be very proud and show all the results they have made in marketing so far. So thank you very much.